हेलो एवरीवन, यू आर ऑल वेलकम टू लेक्चर नंबर 605 एंड टुडेस टॉपिक इज द न्यूट्रिशनल एंड हेल्थ बेनिफिट्स ऑफ पेपे. समटाइम्स यू कॉल इट हॉट पेपे, समटाइम्स यू कॉल इट हॉट चिलीज एंड इन इंडिया वी कॉल इट मिर्चा मिर्ची और शिमला मिर्च. And there are different variety. You know, someone is long, someone is round shape, and someone is spherical shape. Different variety and different shapes are there, but they are all from pepe, a group of fruit. And in North Nigeria, mainly two type of pepe are there. One is called Tata Shai, and the other one is called that is Atarku. So atarku means it is round shape and it is very very hot. What I have seen here, and the long one that is not very hot, it is moderate. And pepe are sold either green, that is not ripe, that is immature, and the second one is when it is ripe, and then it turns into red color, and that red color is very important because red color means it is very rich in lycopene, beta carotene. Actually, they are all carotenoid. Alpha carotenoid is called lycopene, which makes chili super fruit, and it is used as a vegetable, as in India as a vegetable, as well as it is used as a spice, and it is very rich in vitamin C, vitamin E, flavonoids and capsaicin, alkaloid piperine, and that's why the hotness is because of this structure that is called capsaicin. Some people, they have the confusion that it is because of the piperine this one is very hot. No, it is because of capsaicin, and this capsaicin is a very important medicinal compound. Because of this capsaicin, it is hot, and it also works medicinally, in the sense that it is the pepper is very good for your respiratory system, cough, chest congestion, and even nasal congestion. And nowadays, when they are making nasal drop, nasal spray, they are using capsaicin, and this capsaicin will decongest nose, as well as it will decongest the cough and chest. That's why in India, if suppose they want to decongest the cough, they will add little more red chilies or pepe, and then by running nose, by tearing, I mean tears will come out, and nose running will be there, and in this way all this will be sneezed out the cough. So it is very important from respiratory point of view. It is also helping to control the allergy, and the ripe chilies, they are very rich in flavonoids, beta carotenoids, alpha carotenoids, and that alpha carotenoid is I have given here, this one. This is actually carotenoid group, long tail hydrocarbon with lot of unsaturation. The same carbon skeleton is there for all carotenoids. The only difference is that someone is alpha, someone is beta. This group of carotenoid is not converted into vitamin A because it is alpha form. It is called lycopene, and lycopene is very very important, very excellent antioxidant. And those who are regularly eating the ripe red chilies, definitely there is drastically chance of reducing of prostate cancer as well as lung cancer. Is latest research shows that this lycopene, this red color of chili means it is full of lycopene, full of this antioxidant, that is flavonoid, and they are capable of drastically reducing the oxidative stress, and at the same time the cancerous cell growth in brain in the form of tumor or as a prostate or as a lung cancer. So lycopene is responsible of making it super fruit and spice, that is piperine. And this piperine is this flavonoid is there. Capsaicin is bringing hot taste of chili. This piperine is actually alkaloid, and this is only 1%. And another one is also that is piperlongamine. Piperlongamine is also another alkaloid. So these two alkaloids are there in pepe, and this is ligand, that is called sesamine, is also another antioxidant. And of course the super excellent antioxidant is lycopene. I have given all the structures so that you can understand that what is the medicinal and health benefit of pepe. So I have already told you and showed you all the structures like piperine, like flavonoid, beta carotene and lycopene, and how they are important. And because of these antioxidants and vitamin C, vitamin A, anti-inflammatory, and that's why the red pepper is super vegetable, and spice also. In India, it is used for both purpose. And nowadays, we call it curry powder. Actually, curry powder is the mixture of red pepper powder, turmeric powder, cinnamon powder, coriander powder, and they are mixed together, is called curry powder. So that is widely used globally. And here, this pepe, in India we call it mirchi, and the botanical name is Capsicum annuum Linn, and it belongs to family Solanaceae, and also some where it is mentioned Piperaceae. So both are acceptable. Number one, pepe is commonly known as hot pepe or hot chilies, and pepe is aperitif, means it is appetizer. And also it is working as a tonic, and it is rich in flavonoids, vitamin C, vitamin A and vitamin K. These are rich source of antioxidants, and it can prevent eye disease because the red pepper is rich in beta carotene, and that helps to improve the vision in the night. And this red pepper are great source of vitamin B6 and vitamin B9, that is called folate, and folate is very important for boosting our immune system. It's very very important, and that's why nowadays when we are suffering from novel coronavirus attack, it's better to get checked your folate level in blood, because once our blood is full of folate, it drastically protect our respiratory system. So the red chilies, they are super in the sense that it is rich in folates as well as rich in lycopene. That's why it is very very important vegetable, and both of these B6 and B9 also prevent anemia. Those who are anemic, if they take this chili, red chili, it means they are going to pump vitamin B6 and vitamin B9, that is called folate. And also for pregnant women also, I have already told you in some of my lectures that it also plays very important role, and it will not allow the detachment of fetus, once enough folate is taken. And this folate, B9, I am telling you, is very important vitamin for our immune system. I mean, after water soluble vitamin C, the next goes to folate. Because folate very clearly protects the damage of lung cells, and it provides some lubricant type outside the cell so that virus cannot easily damage or enter. Once our folate level is good and high, we are well protected from viral attack. The latest research publications are indicating, and a lot of neurologists, they are publishing paper on it, that better to go for fruit and vegetables which are rich in vitamin C and folate in general, or we can say B complex vitamins. And number two, red pepper is packed with lycopene, and lycopene is anti-cancerous, excellent antioxidant, and makes red pepper super vegetable because of the presence of lycopene, and which prevent many cancers like prostate cancer and lung cancer. It burns more calories, means if you are taking regularly red pepper, it will reduce the chance of obesity to accumulate the fat. And then research shows that red pepper can activate thermogenesis and increase the metabolic rate. Actually, this is the latest research. Otherwise, once anybody who is having acidity or ulcer, the general physician, they will first say stop red chilies, or we can say peppers. But latest research says that it activates the metabolic process and thermogenesis, and because of that, it helps in ulcer. So it's because of the latest findings, it is the informational or research publication is different from what general practitioners they believe. Then the number three is capsaicin. Capsaicin is responsible of making it hot or pungent or bitter, we can say. Where tears can come out if you take not Tata Saheb, but Atarku. Atarku is very, very hot in North Nigeria. So it's because of capsaicin, and capsaicin structure I have already given you. But it is a very good medicinal compound also. Can act as anti-irritant, and also it is good for ulcer, as as per the recent research, it can mitigate migraines. It can help, the migraines, means if you have centralized sparking of headache. So if you take red chilies, it will decentralize that sparking of the pain, and in this way you will get relief. So it is also helping in migraine. It decentralizes the migraine pain. It also relieves joint pain and can fight flu. Can fight flu means it is rich in antioxidants, vitamin C, vitamin A, and folates, especially B9 and B6. Then number four, antioxidants. Flavonoids, beta-carotene, lycopene can reduce oxidative stress and help cardiovascular system. It also prevents allergies due to an anti-inflammatory properties of these antioxidants. And capsaicin can reduce nasal and chest congestion due to cough. And that's why nowadays there is preparation of nasal spray out of capsaicin. So with this I will stop, but in the last but not least, please, nowadays we are suffering from the attack of coronavirus and disease is called COVID-19. So please add in your diet as much as possible vitamin C that we can get from citrus fruit, and after vitamin C, which can boost your immune system and protect your respiratory system is your folate B9 vitamin. B9 vitamin, nowadays lot of research papers I have seen that they are very, very powerful for protecting our lung and respiratory system in general. So please add to your food folate, and even you check the level of folate in your blood. If in case there is deficiency, you can take some supplement. Thank you very much for watching the lecture.